Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. Tonight we're going to talk about Git Hooks. And this box right here that I have right here, that is actually IntelliJ, the stands and creates, it's actually creating a project in the back, and it's actually initializing and preparing the project, indexing, etc., downloading the dependencies. So that's because we're going to use that project in just some minutes. But Git actually has a feature which not everybody knows of, or maybe people actually didn't have time to look into it, or maybe they thought it was a huge subject. It's a very, very small subject actually, but it's a very cool tool to have in the tool belt. It's called Git Hooks. For instance, there's a lot of Git hooks, but one of them is the pre-commit, which I have written down here on the last line, and that actually enables us to actually run some tests before actually committing code. If the cool thing is, or the main thing is actually that we have a folder, and inside this folder, which is called Git hooks, we can actually place scripts with a name like pre-commit and stuff like that. I'll show you this. There are actually a lot of templates, scripts, and a lot of sample scripts there. But you can actually just take one of those, and then I can rename one of those, and then every time I then commit some code, then this shell script will be run. So that means that before actually committing code, then I can run like gradle test or gradle clean test or something like that. If that fails, then the commit will not start. So if the shell script returns something different than zero, then the action that is before will not run. There's a lot of actions. This is from githooks.com. Here we actually have all the hooks. We have something called pre-push also. So that means that just before pushing, we can actually also run some tests if that one we want to. We could actually also we can run whatever we want to run actually. So because it's a shell script, I have actually used pre-push in situations where I could not use something called Git webhooks for my Jenkins. Because of network issues, then I could actually not Jenkins had couldn't have an open URL that GitHub could actually reach, so then I could not use the web hooks directly. What I did was I actually created a script that actually sent a curl message to the Jenkins, which I could reach from my machine, and then I actually started the build job just before pushing, and then I actually had a sleep in my Jenkins build job, and then everything actually worked out in the end, and then I got my project built, and it was also deployed into the tested environment. But that's another story. That's not a case. But in our case, we would like to run before committing. And if the test fail, then we would actually like to stop the commit. But these are all the hooks that we can actually hook up to in Git. So we can also hook up to something like post merge. Then we can do some stuff or pre rebase. But the one that we find interesting in our case right now is the pre commit, which is right there. So let us get started. I have just I cheated a little bit. I created this project just before starting the video, and that was a good thing because now it's done indexing and all that. That means that we actually have, it's a Spring Boot application. I created it by choosing new, the file new, the project, Spring Initializer. I chose Java 13, and I chose Java 13 here, gave it a good name, changed to Gradle, just because I prefer Gradle. And ticked off Lombok, I ticked off Web. I actually also ticked off Thymeleaf, but I'm not going to use it right now. It's just a habit. So, and then I pressed next finish, and then I ended up with this project right here. Here we have the application, and then we have a nice test down here. We have a unit test here, which we can actually run, and we have a Gradle command here. We can run Gradle, or we can run the Gradle W, the Gradle wrapper, which is a bit faster because it caches. But then we can write clean, something like clean test, and then we'll actually have this test run right here, which in our case actually runs successfully. There's actually no content, there's no assertions inside. But while that actually runs, then let us initialize the Git repository. There are multiple ways of doing this. I think we can do it through IntelliJ, but I would actually like to run a command instead out in my terminal. So that's what I'm going to do. So I'm going to say copy path, and then I go to my terminal. Like this, and now I'm actually here in my Git hooks project, and I write git init to get the git initialized. So now I actually have a git folder ls-al. Then I can actually see I have this .git folder right there. If I go inside this .git folder right here, then I can see then I can see I have a folder called hooks, and this is the folder where I can actually place our Git hooks. And it's actually very simple now when you first have tried it and learned how to use it. Actually, there's actually all these sample scripts that are already here. So we can actually take one of the sample scripts if that's what we want to. We can actually take the pre-commit.sample and we can rename it to .sh for shell script instead. So I'm going to copy pre-commits. I like to have the original sample. Then I'm copying this to pre-commit.sh like this. Then I'm going to use vi to go into my pre-commits.sh like this. Then I can see here's a lot of code here. This is actually an example of what we could actually do. We could actually check some differences and attempt to add some non-ASCII file name and all that. They have a lot of good intentions with this big script, but it's too big for me to handle, and it's too big for me to be able to overview. So I'm going to delete all these lines. D100D, that was to delete 100 lines. Okay, it did not. I don't know why. Maybe I should have opened it in IntelliJ instead. So usually you can actually write, when it's the VI, you can write D, and then you can write a number of lines like 99 and D again, and then you should actually delete the next 99 lines. Something like D and then 10 and then D. Okay, maybe the number was too big actually. So D, 20, D, then 20 lines were deleted, and DD, delete the line that I'm actually at right now. And U for U is undo, so if you want this shebang, then we just add there. So this is my pre-commit right now. In my script, I just want to echo hello. I have added a Git hook, so like this, and another echo sentence like yes, it looks like it's working. It's working. Let's commit. So this script here will be run every time I try to commit some stuff. So I'll go out to the root folder again. So now I'm here. And let us just try to add some files, ga dot and git commit and add. I'm using C#, that means I can write some short commands like gcam is git commit and add plus a message, and then I can write first commit like this, and let's see what happens. I don't think anything actually happens. Clear. Let us just clear. Touch new file. .txt. Git.add new. Git add new file. And let us try to git commit stuff. -m. It doesn't work. Git commit that does not work. Okay, let us go back to the .git folder like this. Let's go back to hooks. We have the pre-commit. What happens if I call the pre-commit .sh? No, .sh. I think actually we should just remove the .sample part. Let me try to rename this. Move this to .pre-commit like this. It's still executable, so let us try again to commit some stuff. And new file, .txt, and then we say git add, and then we say git commit, blah blah blah. File removed. Yeah, now it's working. We should not have the .sh postfix. You see here, now I actually committed, then said hello. I have added a git hook. It's working. Let's commit. What I would like to do is actually now I would like to when I write gradlew and then test, I would like to run these tests just before. Or maybe I have not initialized the gradlew error yet. Okay. Gradlew. Okay. I should just not have added that in front. So now the test will run. The first time it always takes a little bit of time. It needs to initialize some stuff. Maybe it also needs to download some dependencies. I need to compile the code, of course. So let's just check what's happening. But we could see that our Git hook actually already works. So if you're impatient, you can actually just stop the video now. Now we actually learned the basic stuff. But I'm going to show. I will try to make it fail now. So hang on if you want to see it fail. Okay. So now we actually tested and built successful. Everything went fine. That is really, really good. But what I would like to do now is actually I would like to make a test fail. So I go to this test right here and then I say, please fail the test. Fail. Like not implemented yet. Oh, fail on purpose. Fail on purpose. Like this. Purpose. Something like this. And then we just go. Did I misspell it somehow? Fail. Assertion.fail, which version are we running here? Okay, we're running the dm.5. Assertions, then we need this fail right here. Assertion.fail, this is Jupyter, this is JUnit5, which is really cool. Let's go out again here. Now let me gradle test this one. Oh, I did the same again, sorry. Let's just check what happens. Start up the Spring Boot context, and then it should fail. Oh, now it failed. So now I'm actually a bit happy because now I'll go vi and then .git and then / hooks, and then I'll take my pre-commit like this, and then I will actually go instead of echoing. And after the echoes, I would actually like to start, then I would actually like to run gradlew test just to test the code before we actually do the commit. Let us see what happens now. So I'll just add a new file, touch file2.txt, then git add, git commit, new file. I could actually also just commit the test changes actually. Gradlew not found. Okay, we need to give it a path. Let me just try again. But actually it failed, so now we did not, because my script failed, it did not fail on what I actually expected it to fail on. It actually failed because it could not find the Gradle wrapper right now, but it actually failed, so that means that I did not, my code is not committed. If I run a status here, then the code is not committed because my script failed. It returns something else than zero. So I actually changed the script. The script is, as we see right here. I wanted to see which folder I'm actually in, and the current folder is actually the folder that we actually located in. So the directory path is not changed, and then I'm running the gradlew and then clean and test. That means that we will get the code compiled again, and then we will test it afterwards. So let me just go out, and then we will see if it works. I'll just touch file3.txt. Then we'll add that, and then we'll commit test. Just run test. We can see here path is blah 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 my home folder, and then the Git hooks. This is a project that we're currently in, and this is echoes that that we added in the pre-commit script. And now it is cleaning first, and then it's compiling. And the good thing about using the Gradle wrapper, then it's always just the correct version of everything that is used. So that's okay. Now we actually now we could actually commit. Let's try to introduce the error once again. And let's try to change the test again to fail. And let's see that we cannot commit again once again. And I go out here, I say I want to commit again. Now we have some tests that actually fails. We will be allowed to commit. Of course, I could have chosen some easier test right now. It's kind of integration test when we start the whole Spring context. We could also have some small unit tests that is very fast to run. And actually now we can see now we cannot commit because there was actually an error. Please fix the error. Yes, I will fix the error once again. And let us see it once again. Commit with the node test. And that's actually it. Now we could commit the code again. Thank you very much for listening and watching tonight. If you like this video, of course, I would appreciate if you press the like button. If you subscribe, then we get more content from me. I hope to see you again very soon. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.